everyone. My name is Monique. If you're new to the channel, thanks so much for being with me today. Before we get into the meat of our topic, I first wanted to give a huge shout out to my husband. Thanks so much for being so supportive. He was the guy at the clip at the beginning of this video. We did that on a whim. It was such an impromptu thing, but he was so game, so up for it. So thank you for doing that for me. And you'll probably see a lot more of him in the next couple of episodes. So thinking about the clip at the beginning of this video, I think it's such a reflection of, at least for me, the many, many times that I've second-guessed myself, the times that I've wondered whether or not I was making the right choice, especially during the times when I wanted to drive a point across to my children, or I quote-unquote wanted to teach them a lesson. And when we think about what happened in the video, when we chose to leave the book out, knowing full well that, you know, we live in Vancouver, it rains a lot, that the book will probably get wet, choosing to leave it out instead of bringing it in, we are allowing our children to feel the natural consequence of their actions. We're allowing them to live out or experience what will probably happen as a result of the choices that they make. And should that make us feel bad? Should that make us feel guilty or think that we're a bad parent because we didn't save the book, we didn't bring it inside to keep it dry? But when you think about it, even for us adults, and I think especially for children, how do we learn? We learn through trial and error. We learn by making mistakes. We learn when we choose to do one thing and it results into a bad thing or something that we don't really want happening, that we could have made a better choice or we could have done something differently. And with our children, every day, even in the most mundane of things, for example, with Raphael running around with a cup full of water, there is always that opportunity to quote-unquote teach them a lesson or show them the consequences of their actions, because with everything that we do, with everything that our children do, there's always an event that would follow, good or bad. And it's up to us adults, parents, to either take a step back and watch the consequence unfold, or we step in and intervene. And when we talk about guilt-free ways of managing behavior or teaching our children a lesson, I think as long as we know that our children are safe, that when we let these natural consequences to occur, that we're not hurting others, we're not hurting our children. Like in the video, I know that I asked my husband to act it out, but it actually happened to us. And I was faced with a choice of leaving the book out or bringing it in. And I thought to myself, if I leave the book out and it does get wet, it's not going to hurt my children, and it might be a more effective way of driving the point across that they should take care of their things. And when that does happen, I think what's more important is that we refrain from saying "I told you so" and really try to have that respectful conversation with our children about the consequences of their actions.
Nene, look, this is an outdoor movie, but
hi, girls.
Hi.
Can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure. Pop.
Can you put the book aside?
Okay. Pop.
Thank you. So, I found your book outside and it's all wet. Why do you think it's wet?
Because we left it outside and it rained and it got wet.
How do you feel about it?
It doesn't feel good. Sorry.
What are we going to do about your books next time?
Next time we're gonna think and remember and then put it back where it belongs. Sorry, Daddy.
Okay.
Okay. I'm squished.
Sometimes, though, natural consequences aren't enough, and there are certain situations wherein for our children to really learn the lesson, for them to truly understand what is going on, what is happening, we are put in this unique position to create a consequence. And what I try to do for myself so that I don't feel guilty and I don't feel like I'm a bad parent is that I create a consequence that is logical. For example, if Raphael is running around with a cup full of water, the natural consequence of that is that he spills everything on himself and he gets wet, or he spills everything on the floor and everything gets wet. But if I were to create a consequence and I ask him to stand in the corner, and then it doesn't connect with what has actually happened. It's illogical. And when we do that, we make our children feel like we're punishing them. And that's not really what we want them to feel or what we want them to learn. We want them to realize that when they do a certain action, that this naturally occurs after that, and this is something that they would have to do to correct that. So a logical consequence to Raphael spilling water on the floor would be for him to clean it up. And when I do that, when I do something that's logical, when I create a consequence that is connected to what has actually happened, then my son, Raphael, hopefully realizes that, oh, if I don't want to be mopping the floor up with a paper towel, then maybe next time I can be more careful when I carry a cup full of water around the house. I think the word consequence has such a negative connotation for a lot of people. In our home, lately, I've been finding myself having this conversation with Matina and Renee a lot, and I say, consequences are neither good or bad. It's a fact of life. It's something that happens after something you say or something you do, and it results into something positive or something that's not so positive, and you learn from it. So I hope this video makes you feel a little bit better about making consequences and giving your children consequences. You know, at the end of the day, I think we all try to do our best, and we all try to be good parents, and you know, every day is a new day. We learn from yesterday. We try again tomorrow. And really, that's all that matters. Thanks for joining me in this episode. If you learned anything at all, I hope you're able to share this episode with others and subscribe to my channel. I will see you next time. But until then, remember to make every day your own version of extraordinary.